Hi, welcome to the session. I am Priyanka Sadana, a PM with Microsoft Project Team. Today, I'll be talking about reporting in Project for the Web. I hope you enjoy this session. So if your organization decides to use Project for the Web to manage your projects, how do your executives, the PMO, or your team get information on all your plans, portfolios, or resources? Power BI solves this problem for you. So today, the agenda is that I'll be talking about Project for the Web Power BI templates that Microsoft Project Team has provided along with Project for the Web. Then we'll see how we can extend these Power BI templates and build your reporting solutions in a Power Apps. I'll take you through a quick recap of the Power BI templates. The content pack has 9 report pages in total. The first 3 focus on roll-up of projects into a portfolio. Portfolio dashboards give a quick overview of aggregated information on efforts and task status across all your projects. The portfolio timeline shows visually where all your projects fall on timeline, including their duration and progress to date. And the portfolio milestone report summarizes all milestones completed in past 30 days or listed to be completed in past 30 days, as well as milestones planned for next 30 days. The next two have resource focus. The resource report includes dashboards that show what people are working on. A project executive might use these reports to understand what everybody is doing. And the last 4 drill down to task level, including work for individuals and the timelines. So these reports provide a good starting point for creating a set of reports on your own. There is no one project management solution that suits everybody, nor do the reports. Hence, these reports have to be adapted to respective processes and needs of your own organization. So first, we'll start with how do you get started with these reports. You need a Power BI desktop license and Power BI template file. You can find the template file at aka.msprojectreports. In the template pop-out window, you can enter the URL for your Dataverse environment. And selecting the information icon there will take you to a help document that can help you determine your URL for Dataverse environment. The easiest way is to go to your project home application, hover over your project for the org you want to report on and copy the URL from there and use it. Next, you'll be asked to sign in. You follow the authorization process. That's it. Power BI will load all your data into your reports. So you can see that status of all your projects and your resources in your dashboards. Let's take a new example. In project management, getting an early indication of problems is really important for a project manager. It allows project manager to correct the problems even before they start. So using the project for the web data, let's build a variance report. I can show you an example here. So we'll take an example of schedule variance here. From a variance report, the team can see if the work they are getting done is actually the project's targets or whether they're just spending time without ticking off the project milestones or project deliverables. For calculating variance, I would need planned values and earned values per task. The earned value is calculated on how much the task is done multiplied by budget per task, and the planned value is how much task was supposed to be done by today multiplied by task budget. So for this example, my assumption is that my task budget is equal to fixed cost into the number of resources that are assigned to the task. So here I'm going to open transform data. I'll make a new query here. So I would be needing data from these 3 tables, the task team staging table, the project task staging table, and the project staging table. I'll use one of the tables as my basic source first. In the next step, I'll merge another table with this one. So click on Merge Queries, and here you can select the table. I need the project staging table, and I'll join both these tables on the project ID. So here we go. You can see that we have joined both the tables. I'll expand the second table. Then following the same steps, I'll add another table here. That was the project task staging table from which I would be needing duration information on the task. These 2 tables I'll be joining on task IDs. Here we go. Similarly, I'll expand this table as well. So there's a lot of information in these 3 tables combined, which I won't be needing for calculating my planned or earned values. I'll clean this table and remove the columns that I do not need. For that, you have to go and click on Choose Columns, and you can select the columns that would be required. Since I already have that in my SPI step one, so this is the way you will get your data. I only have the data that I require here. Now I'll start my calculations over this. I'll go to add a new column. I'll add a custom column. And as I said, I'll take a constant value for task budget. Let's take a value of 100 here. Okay. Now I'll be calculating my earned value. Similarly, you can do this, follow the same step. As I told earlier, earned value is your completed effort over your total effort for a task into your task budget. So this is how we'll calculate earned value. Similarly, you can calculate planned value. And I have these values calculated in my SPI step two. So I'll be removing these columns from here. So you can see here that I have my calculated all the values, the planned values and earned values. So for planned values, I needed net working days between today's date and the starting date. For that, I have written a function which gives returns the value of number of days that have passed from your starting date to your current date, removing all the weekends in between. So I'll go and I'll close and apply. Here I won't be doing that since I already have these values in my tables. Coming on to visual, you can select a clustered column chart from here, and in a shared axis you can put project title, and your column values will be planned value, earned value. And to calculate variance, you can just go and create a quick measure. You can see that you can add any kind of operation from here. I have taken subtraction and planned values and the earned value difference. So this is my variance. You can see that I've added variance to this visual as well. Moving on to next example. Let's say you wanted to see your schedule variance for your departments and not just for projects. But project for the web does not by default give department values. But since it's based on Power Platform, you can customize or extend your project for the web. I'll show an example on how to do that. For that, we'll open make.powerapps.com. So here, if you scroll down and open your project application, you can see that I've added a department entity here. How to do that? For that, go to make.powerapps.com again. Click on data and tables. Find your project tables here. If you're not able to locate a project table, if it doesn't show it up here, change this to all from managed or custom. Select your project. And here you can add a column. If you add a column, let's say department 5. From this drop down, select data type as choices if you want to provide choice for this. And you can go and add new choices here. Click on done, and then you have to save table to save this entity. Now you can see that your table has the department field here. Next up, you have to move on to views. Select all project. Here you have to keep this show only unused table columns checked. From there, we'll take department 5 and we'll add it here to our view. Yeah, it's here. I'll reorder it. You can save and then publish. Once it's published, move on to forms. Select information. And you can drag the column here. I won't be adding it since I already have a department column here. Similarly, save and publish this. Go back. Now our table is updated. We'll go ahead and create a new application. We'll name it Project for the web. Click on Done. And here in the sitemap, you need to configure what all information this application will have. Let's call this project. We'll link this project to the project entity. Click on save and then publish. If you scroll down, you can see that we have project for the web demo here, but since it's not published, that's why it's not clickable. Save it and then publish. If you open this application now, you can see that your project will have a department information linked with it here. And you can change it or select any of the values. Now I want to add my Power BI dashboard here as well. So what I'll do is I'll go back to my template. And there, how do I add these departments? I'll go to transform data again. And if you go to your project staging table, you can see that the department data is already there. In your SPI step one table, if your department data is not flowing, just open the, click on the gear of removed other columns. Search for your department and you can select it. So if you see here, if we have your variances across departments, if you want to see how each of your how each of the projects in your department is performing, you can drill down on the report, click on any of the departments, and you can see the distribution of variances across projects of that particular department. So your reports are ready. You can just publish them for your team to consume. Moving on to your Power BI service, you can see here that your reports are published. And anyone in your organization can consume these reports. So how do we integrate these reports back into your Power app? I'll show you an example here. So if I click here on project for the web, you can see that I have these Power BI reports for all my projects embedded here. So how do you embed these reports in your Power app application? Here, I'll go to make.powerapps again. It's the home page. I'll open my application and then I'll click on edit. In your sitemap, you can add another sub area, another group, call them reports and dashboards. So here, we'll add a web resource, and that web resource will be our Power BI application. How do we create that? Here I can show you an example that I have an embedded report created here. How do you create, go and create this? openmake.powerapps.com, navigate to solutions, add a new solution here. Let's call it embedded report demo. Click on create. Now we edit it. Add a new web resource here. Select type as web page and move on to your text editor. For source, you have to go back to your Power BI service, click on share, click on embed report, and then publish to web. Copy the HTML for your website. We have it copied to clipboard. And we'll paste it here. Change your iframe width to 100%. And height as well. Click on rich text to see if your report data is flowing here. We can see that our reports are loading just fine. Click on OK. And then publish all customization. Once it's published, go to your app designer again. Select your sub area. Select web resource here and in a URL. So it will take some time to sync. And so I'll use embedded reports, which I made earlier. You save it. And then you publish. Close it and then save it again. Let's move back to our application. You can see new sub area here with your Power BI reports. So that concludes our demo. Go and try it for yourself. Thanks for watching this session. I hope you find it useful. Do watch out our sessions, Extensibility in Project for the Web and Project Accelerator. And for any feedback, please provide it to us through our in-app feedback. Or if you have any doubts, please write to priyanka.sudhana@microsoft.com. Thank you.